Good afternoon, madam. Today we discuss about metabolism, drug metabolism, part 2. It means phase and reactions. So we need to discuss about definition and phase and reaction today. So definition already we have discussed, even though once again we discuss. So in a chemical reaction, the presence of the enzyme, the conversion of drugs into metabolites within your body is called drug metabolism. In another way, we can say that the biochemical modification of one compound, one chemical form to another chemical form, the presence of enzyme, is called drug metabolism. So we can divide into two categories. One is phase 1 reaction, another one is phase 2 reaction. Phase 1, another name we can call is functionalization reaction. Phase 2, another reaction we can call as conjugation reaction. In phase 1, it contains three types of reactions. One is oxidation, reduction, hydrolysis. The three reactions reduce the increase the polarity of molecule and given charge to secondary metabolic reaction. This reaction we can call as functionalization reaction. This third transformation also called as synthetic reaction. So one name is functionalization reaction, other name is synthetic reaction. Third one is opposite to synthetic phase 2 reactions. So what are the groups comes under the functionalization reaction? One is hydroxyl group, thio group, carboxyl group and amino group are called as xenobiotics. These groups are giving more yield of water soluble chemical entity. So here I have given summarized phase 1 reactions. Phase 1 reaction contains three types of reactions. One is oxidative reaction, second one is reductive reaction, third one is hydrolytic reactions. So here we will see one by one. First one is oxidative reaction. So oxidative reaction is nothing but oxidation. So oxidation means addition of oxygen or loss of proton. So here loss of electrons from a substance in a reaction is called oxidative reaction. So generally this is a common oxidation reaction in xenobiotics. So the polar functional groups are increase the lipophilic character of xenobiotics. So with the use of cytochrome 450, the cytochrome 450 required to give more effect of reaction of molecular oxygen and reducing the agent of NADPH. In simplify that, so common reaction, so polar functional group giving increase this hydrophilic character of xenobiotics. So third point is telling that we need some catalyst, that means cytochrome 450. If cytochrome 450 required oxygen and reducing agent to give more effect of reaction. So here I have given simplified reaction. So RH, that means alkene group undergoes oxidation in presence of reducing agent with a proton to give alcohol, water molecule and nicotine adenine diphosphate. So coming to this first reaction, so oxidation of aromatic carbon atom. So nothing but here, so aromatic hydroxylation refers to mixed function of oxidation aromatic compounds to their corresponding phenols. The reactions proceed via formation of reactive intermediate arene oxide or arene epoxide, which results in multiple reaction. So these two points telling that, for example, I have given three type of reactions. One is green color, yellow color and red color. So green color, by seeing the green color, so one is benzene ring with one alkyl group, it gives undergoes hydroxylation to gives 4-hydroxy substituted benzene ring. So here addition of OH group, addition of hydroxyl group. So in yellow color, same as hydroxylation, addition of hydroxylation. So isocyanate undergoes hydroxylation to give 4-hydroxy acetanilide. All the three reactions, all the aromatic hydroxyl reaction through epoxy, arene epoxy or arene oxide formation of these groups and finally getting addition OH group to the final structure. So this is the intermediate compound of other reactants, epoxy, arene oxide or arene epoxy is the intermediate compound of particular reaction. So next one is oxidation of olefins. Olefin nothing but double bonded carbon atom. So oxidation of non-aromatic carbon-carbon double bond is analog to aromatic hydroxylation. It proceeds via epoxy to yield 1,2 dihydrodiol. The epoxy is not very reactive like aromatic epoxide. So nothing but here oxidation carried out in a double bond carbon atom, that means olefin atoms. So here also, so through epoxy formation of epoxy ions in the intermediate state, finally giving final product. But the final product is very accurate with use of epoxy ions. For example, here I have given carbamazepine undergoes oxidation to give intermediate product of epoxy ions. So then reproducing trans 10-11 dihydroxy carbamazepine, formation of 2 OH group and breakdown of epoxy atoms. So another example is aciclofenac. The aciclofenac, so formation of epoxy, then final product is dihydroxy aciclofenac. So next reaction is oxidation of benzylic reaction. So here benzylic group, benzene ring with the double bond carbon atom. So carbon atom attached directly to the aromatic ring is hydroxylated to corresponding carbonyls or alcoholic metabolite. So nothing but here, so for example here dolubutamide undergoes oxidation to gives formation of alcohol. Again undergoes alcohol dehydrogenase with use of enzyme reproducing acid group. The primary alcohol metabolite is further oxidized to alkyne and further to carboxylic acid, and secondary albumin gets converted to ketone by alcohol and aldehyde dehydrogenase respectively. So these are common things of oxidation. So alkyl group undergoes oxidation will give alcohol. Alcohol again oxidizes to give acid. So you have same thing. So secondary alcohol gives ketone by alcohol with the use of dehydrogenase enzymes respectively. So next oxidation is allylic carbon. The carbon atom adjacent to olefinic double bond undergoes hydroxylation similar to the benzylic reaction. So benzylic reaction same as here also. So olefinic double bond undergoes hydroxylation. So here example I have given. So hexabarbital undergoes hydroxylation to give 3 hydroxy hexabarbital, formation of OH group and one ring. Another one is saffron undergoes oxidation, that means oxidation of allylic carbon. Example is saffron undergoes hydroxylation, that means hydroxylation to give hydroxy saffron. So next reaction is oxidation of carbon atom alpha to carbonyl and imines. The mixed function oxidase also oxidize carbon atom adjacent to carbonyl and imino functionalities. So nothing but here enzyme as well as carbon atom also oxidized to carbonyl and imino functionalities. For example here diazepam undergoes oxidation to give 3 hydroxy diazepam or N-methyl oxazepam, finally undergoes demethylation to form oxazepam. So next one is oxidation of aliphatic carbon atom. This is a general and common reactions. So alcohol undergoes oxidation to give acid. Again acid undergoes oxidation, it become 4 hydroxy valporic acid. This is a major product. So next one is oxidation of alicyclic carbon atom. So example here amphetamine undergoes oxidation to give trans 4 hydroxy acetoxamide. So other reactions such as oxidation reactions such as oxidation involving carbon nitrogen system, that means amines reaction, oxidation of carbon sulfur system, oxidation of alcohol and aldehyde system. So we have different type of oxidative reactions. So next one is reduction reactions. So reduction reaction is an important role in metabolism of many compounds containing carbonyl, nitro and azo group. So bioreduction of carbonyl group results in alcohol, whereas nitro and azo group gives to rise to amino group. The amino and hydroxyl group are more susceptible to conjugate. So this point telling that is one of the important reaction for carbonyl, nitro and azo group compounds. So bioreduction of carbonyl group gives result in alcohol. So whereas nitro and azo groups gives rise to amino group. The amino hydroxyl group are more reactive to conjugate. Reactive or susceptible or easy to conjugate with the others. For example, I have given here example warfarin. So warfarin undergoes reduction reaction. So to give alcohol diastereomer. Another example is methadone. Methadone undergoes reduction reaction. So methadol. So before that reduction, reduction nothing but addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen. This is called reduction reaction. So next one is reduction of azo and nitro compounds. So here with the use of reaction, nitro compound undergoes reduction, it's called nitroso. Nitroso compound undergoes reduction and become hydroxylamine. So hydroxylamine undergoes oxidation reduction to give its primary amine. So same thing, example here, nitrazibum undergoes reduction and become 7 amino metabolite. So the third one major reaction is hydrolytic reaction. So here hydrolysis of ester and amides. So with the use of structure, aspirin is here undergoes hydrolysis to give salicylic acid and acetic acid. So hydrolysis, so breakdown of water molecule with the use of water molecule. Next one is hydrolysis of amide. So propanamide undergoes hydrolysis to give para amino benzoic acid and 1 amino 2 to diethyl amino ethanol. So these are three main reactions are very important for fusion reaction. So once again we call that, so fusion reaction contains three reactions: oxidative reaction, reduction reaction, last one is hydrolytic reactions. So we have many types of oxidation reactions, for example carbon nitrogen, carbon sulfur, carbon to aromatic ring, carbon to benzylic ring, carbon to alicyclic ring, carbon to alcohol and aldehyde reactions, etc. So coming to this reduction reaction, so reduction to amide, acid, alcohol, etc. So these are reactions very important for fusion reaction. So we need to give at least each one reaction for example. So thank you to all. So next class we'll discuss about phase 2 reactions. Thank you.